Amerikick Extravaganza.
Mario Garcia, Natalie Perron, Gavin Hoff,
Casey Chung, Ashley Chung, Roscoe Chung, and Karen Spotton.
Brooklyn in the house, everyone. Brooklyn in the house.
From Amerikick, Princeton, Jackson Woods, Ashley Mike Cunha, Luis Medina, Brandon Roberts, William Howe, Umar Mercedes, Anika Trautellis, Aiden Ames, Grayshawn Ames, Ryan Davis, Warren Eager, and Daniel Dennis.
And the rest of the state of New Jersey is this.
From Amerikick, South Philly, Joseph Tompkins.
Showcase the kids, but also to give you guys and ladies in the crowd something to celebrate, you know? This is a great milestone achievement for these students who've been working hard and been dedicated. So we're going to switch over to a little video tribute, a little montage of Grandmaster. So for those of you that didn't know him, he was a wonderful person, and without him, we would not be here. The founder of America, Dennis Dosen.
time you see something you like, make some noise. Sensei Amerikick, everyone.
Amerikick most of his life. Watch this.
Joseph Starring is the next Iron Man, everybody. Fun fact.
Let's go, Amerikick! Let's go!
That's right. That's right.
Clap, 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 clap. Sounds like Gavin has some fans out here. Does Gavin have fans out here today?
Go, Gavin!
They love you, bro! Give us the show! He's ready.
I need you.
Frank DeMaio.
Let's go.
Mark, are you pumped for this performance, Mark?
I'm a little partial to this team, I must say.
Oh, stretch, give it up, what's your support?
Dora, Yusuf, Webb.
Yusuf brought a fan club. Give it up, everybody.
Yusuf's family, we can't hear you.
Yusuf!
No idea what you said, but that sounded awesome.
Oh!
got a fan club. Give it up again. Give it up, give it up, give it up.
Go out.
Take that stage, Joe. Take that stage.
Let's hear some love for Joey out there. Let's go.
Hey!
folks. Brian, give it up, everybody.
I can't move in anymore, and I am back to home. Hold on.
instructors in American ones.
Now, Amerikick Marlton, Gavin Cooper, Tom Cotella, Sam Matthew, and David Gill, and Sloan Lindsay. Okay, gang. Fellowship, Liam Krizak, K-Van Villain Van, Caitlin Wiggins, Sarah Makuz-Mazuka, Vivian Tran, and Zachary Della Rosario. Sasidaran. Woo! Let's go, Beta!
Pennsylvania Amerikick Black Belt Test, this young lady Veda scored the highest of all American
I'm gonna be saucer. I'm sure
what
I'm
going
to throw away. Man, I'm way too fast. This is a worthless danger. But I just feel
hey.
Oscar Krug, Adam Petticula, Max Zelinski, Rishi Lam, Akshay Supavi, Hai Din Bog, Joe Canale, and Ethan Lip.
Let's go!
perfect weather.
Journey and the fact that he's here with us today. He's going to read his essay. He's going to share his story with all of you.
I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Carl from Amerikick, Northeast Philadelphia. Long one, so I'll just get to it. So, the black belt is a symbol of one's journey. My journey to get to the test started when I was just a child. The journey felt a sudden halt in time, but really, it was just a change in the wind. Over time, my body, my mind, were built up to that of a fighter, and the warrior ethos has never left me. It has only led me to seek more information. Knowledge is power. There would be no power gained without the pursuit of knowledge. The ethos, the pursuit, and the obstacles all in the way are all part of the journey. When I was 5 years old, I was enrolled in Beach Kempo in Virginia Beach in my area. My classes were run by parents of students who held ranks from fourth Q to first Dan, and the adult classes were run by Sensei Allen. That's all I can remember is name, huh? So we would spark, form kata, test out in front of everyone to obtain the next belt. I made it to junior blue belt and was only days away from green before I unfortunately was unable to attend further classes due to life changes far beyond that which an 8-year-old could control. But that which I could control with self-practice and of the basics, doing karate alone in my bedroom, became a very important part of the next chapter of my life. My family had moved out from the security of military housing and into a nearby neighborhood called Glenwood that was less than hospitable. Many bullies and thugs made a name for Glenwood as a rough place to grow up. Had I not had the confidence in myself to defend myself when needed, as well as the skills to back up said confidence, those years in Glenwood would have been significantly worse. That said, it would be safe to say I obtained some experience in fighting that was much needed before the move to the great city of Philadelphia. By the time I made it to Philly, I had learned well when to fight and when to run. This was a useful skill, as it seemed the same bully mindset existed in my new home, just an increasing level of intensity. Not proud to say, that I'd been in too many fights in my teenage years. But I'm happy to report that I was never seriously injured, concussions and broken noses aside. And it hardened me up to be able to take the next step of my life's journey. On July 14th of 2008, I was shipped off to Parris Island, South Carolina to start basic training for the United States Marine Corps. The boot camp. Thank you. In boot camp, we learned simply how to take a life. Part of training involved earning a tan belt in the Marine Corps Martial Arts Program called MCMAT. This included several hours of training in basic techniques, all derived from various other martial arts, including the Mountain Kung Fu, Kyokushin, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Judo, and Chinese Kempo. From there, I moved into infantry training school, where the goal of that training was more focused on team and squad-based tactics, all for the purpose of making us more efficient warriors. After making it to the fleet, the job became training or fighting. During my enlistment, I served in two combat tours to Marj, Afghanistan in the Helmand province in 2010 and 2011. My first deployment was in the last major offensive in all of Operation Enduring Freedom. During my second deployment, I was lucky enough to have a little extra time to test out for higher MCMAT belts and left Afghanistan as a brown belt. After 4.5 years, I was honorably discharged and shortly after started my career as a paramedic, as well as starting a family. During paramedic school, my wife gave birth to our beautiful daughter, Alina, also known as Ellie. And during those days, I did not take proper care of my physical health. Felt myself fatter, weaker, and slower, weighing as high as 192 pounds and only 5'7". Yeah, I'm short. I left the Corps weighing 160 for reference. It's about what I am now. Luckily, a fellow Marine brother of mine had recently become a personal trainer, took me under his wing as a client, and with his assistance and my determination, I was able to get back in the shape I wanted. But once I reached my personal weight, speed, and strength goals, I needed a new goal. I was genuinely inspired by my wife, Leah, and her yoga practice. Her becoming a yoga teacher made me seek after a practice of my own. That's when I decided to start training in the art of American Kempo Karate. I was able to find an old tape of the late senior grandmaster of the arts, Edmund Parker, and I ran through the basics while explaining his words, letters, sentences, concept on performing techniques. I then expanded my studies to that of the grandmaster, Larry Tatum, and his methods on teaching certain 8th Q level techniques. This was all through free resources found online. In this time, I learned more about the history of American Kempo, its roots in Hawaii with Master William K.S. Chow, and the great divide that took place after Senior Grandmaster Parker's death. I also obtained knowledge of a new Kempo curriculum under the current Grandmaster Jeff Speakman called Kempo 5.0. This method of Kempo interested me because mostly due to paying more focus on ground fighting, grappling, and submissions. As a Father's Day gift, I had received a collection of Kempo 5.0 DVDs running through the curriculum from white to black, which I incorporated in my regular physical fitness training. Though, even with all the resources at my disposal, I knew there was something missing. I needed a proper teacher. I needed a Kempo sensei. Where's he at?
He's practicing.
During my home training, my daughter Ellie showed genuine interest in the martial arts. I tried my best to show her how to do the basics, the star block in particular, but I lacked the skills to properly teach at that time, so the search began immediately to find a dojo. Did attempt to find a Kempo 5.0 school, wasn't in the cards. Discussing this dilemma with a close friend of mine, I learned their daughter already attended karate classes at Amerikick Northeast Philly. Yeah. So I called, and Ellie did a trial class. She absolutely and immediately fell in love with it, and her senseis. And she's a red belt now. She'll be here in a year. The timing could not have been more perfect. This was within the same month as the aforementioned Father's Day, and the dojo was running a promotion for fathers of students. After attending one class, I was more than interested. Sensei Mark Gallagher even took the time out to talk to me about my own background in martial arts and to share with me the lineage of his dojo. She goes, Sensei Mark.
Bobby Carl.
Grandmaster Dennis Toaston, and then Senior Grandmaster Edmund Parker, who trained him. The stars must have been aligned that day, because this opportunity was too perfect to pass up. Though I was hesitant due to financial reasons, my amazing wife was an inspiration and she promised me that we'd get through it. So I signed up and never looked back. A little more than 4 years later, and this is where my journey has brought me. I've stayed humble throughout and intend to remain humble, but I'd be lying if I said I wasn't confident in my capabilities as a Kempoist. I'm going to arrive here and then at my black belt test. Sorry, this was written before the black belt test. I'll just read that sentence. I'm going to arrive at my black belt test and I'm going to pass. If I was not confident in this, I would respectfully decline testing. With that said, my sensei is equally confident, if not more, in what I can do. And I can't wait to see where my journey takes me after. The black belt will be a representation of my journey, not the end. Asa!
So I'm just going to ask Carl a couple of questions. This is off the cuff. I didn't give any questions. Knowing that you have a daughter out there, she's a red belt. So what's maybe some advice you would give to her as she continues her journey and she's, you know, one step away from her destination? So speaking to your daughter.
So, Ellie, I can't see where you are.
Ellie, you out there? Where are you at, Ellie?
So, Ellie, what I would tell you is just keep doing what you're doing. You're in demo team, you're killing it on the mats, you're regularly bringing home first, second, third place from the tournaments. Keep doing what you're doing, maybe keep watching what I'm doing, and you'll see how you can get this far. You're gonna do it, kiddo, I believe in you.
Wow. I got one more question for you, because I know there's a lot of parents out there, and, you know, our circle is really, it's about our kids, so we make friends with the different parents of the activities. So maybe what's one piece of advice you'd give to any of the parents who are maybe feeling the same way you felt? Out of shape, not happy with where they're at, you know, physically, health-wise, medically, whatever. You know, what are you going to tell them to maybe motivate them to get them going on their goals?
So I think what I would tell those people is first, set a goal. Even if that goal is just to do 5 push-ups a day, and those push-ups are going to get easier every day, and after it gets hard. But then it gets easier, I promise. More than that, honestly, if you're hesitant on joining, join. It's a great workout. These guys really do work, yeah, I promise you. And not only is it a good workout, but it's a good community, a good understanding community. Like, you're not going to be judged. Everybody just wants you to succeed. And that's what I love most about being a part of Amerikick. All I can really say is set goals and don't stop. Just keep going.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Carl Sheridan. Now, just welcome to the Black Belt family.
Ha! Go.
One of my top instructors, and even more proud to say, scored the highest test in the senior Amerikick black belt test, and today earning his second. Alright, also earning second degree black belt, let's give a hand for Jake Sisko. Come on, Jake. Okay, also earning second degree black belt from our Amerikick EHT, saw her performing earlier. We have Kayvon, and I'm gonna go with the last name. Where's Kayvon at? Okay, Kayvon. Villivon, I don't want to butcher. Hey, Von, come up here. Earning second degree black belt, Jenna Schaefer.
Earning second degree black belt, Bobby Preston. Also earning second degree black belt, Joseph Canale. Also earning second degree black belt, Marquise Downey.
All right, and now earning third degree black belt, been training for a very long time with us, down in South Philly and Northeast Philly. Let's give it up for Johnny Nunez. Okay, these two promotions, special promotions, we like to recognize an award. So first up, I'd like to call to stage. This person is earning fourth degree black belt, and this person is one of our amazing top senseis from our New York group of schools. You saw them up here performing. They were a brother team demonstrating on each other. And they've been with us for a very long time, running multiple schools up there. And this gentleman also is such an integral part of our association. He was a former competitor when he was younger. He started when he was a teenager. He competed in sport karate tournaments. Also a very accomplished collegiate athletic wrestler with many accomplishments as well. Father of three, and he's teaching all the time, so we like to recognize Sensei Vlad Davidoff for fourth degree black belt. And we can stand and sit behind her. Oh, there he is. And his brother, Sensei Alex. Very well deserved, Sensei. Okay, and then we have another special promotion, and this gentleman will be earning fifth degree black belt, which in our style is considered a master level style. He actually has been training since he was a teenager as well. I met him, this is a quick story, when Grandmaster Tosin was at my school as a guest instructor, probably 1997, 98, something like that, when I just opened up my school in Marlton, and Grandmaster and I were out to dinner, and he was actually our server. And he took care of us, and he was talking with us. He recognized that we were talking martial arts and how he trained in Taekwondo. And after a great dinner that he helped us with, he ended up coming to my school and joining and then working and becoming my partner. We opened up many schools together, and he is an amazing integral part of our Amerikick Association. Many of you know him when I say his name, and you know how much he does for us and for our black belts, for our junior instructors, teaching and training, and that will be Sensei Mike Recinto. Oh, there he is. So we're going to ask our black belts here, promotions. Let's give them one more hands, first of all. Sensei, we'd like you to take off your old black belts, tuck that in under your, and put your new black belts on so we can get a nice picture with your new black belts real quick. So as they do that. There we go. And we have their certificates as well, so we'll do a group picture in a second. Where's our photographer? Sensei? Axel, right there? Okay.
Or anybody with an Apple iPhone.
That's what I think he has, actually. So.
Portrait mode. The gentleman handing out the certificates is Mark Gallagher. He's pretty awesome, too.
All right, Sensei, take maybe two steps to your left so we can center you up a little bit. As Sensei's...
Grab you.
Yeah. Are we good, Sensei, sir? Yep, all right, cool. All right, let's hold those certificates up, please. Belt. Ladies and gentlemen, one more hand for our promotions here. One more degrees. All right, and before you go, and before we have our great finale that you're going to see in a minute, we have one more. This person who's been with us for over 15 years, and this person has helped and supported at all of our events. This person is here tonight as well. You'll recognize who this person is. Her son earned third degree black belt and has been with us since he was a little guy. I guess I kind of half gave it away there. We are very excited for this special recognition and honorary black belt. Sensei Mike.
You know, Sandy's been here for many, many years, and even though her son does not compete anymore, she comes to every tournament, she's at every extravaganza, and she's doing the belt. She's an amazing lady, right? She never says no. She trains all, and especially on the PA side. When she comes to those tournaments, she trains all the scorekeepers and everything like that. And we're very proud to present her with her honorary black belt.
All right, and we said we had one more, but we have another one more, so. All right, last one. Grandmaster Tosin, who was all of our instructors, as you know, and founded Amerikick 1967, it's a very long time ago. He was all of our instructors, and as we know, he passed last year, and we have started a tradition where we're honoring him and his spirit. He taught us so much in life, not just martial arts, but life lessons, how to give back, how to be caring, how to be a great person. It's not just about yourself, it's about others, and we try and live by that every day in what we do, and we love what we do, and every day we're teaching and trying to develop and help everybody and inspire to make great lives for everybody. And this person, I've had the pleasure of calling a friend for a very long time. He was actually, even before my time, with Grandmaster Tosin as one of his first students. And he is one of our, I don't want to get too emotional, but one of our guys who are just there all the time with us in every event that we do, from our testings to our tournaments, behind the scenes, and he is in charge of our testings. And we want to recognize Sensei Mike Sautner as the speaker. When the show was going, for those of you who've been here before, Grandmaster Tosin was the MC, and he had a special stool that we had just back there, and we were recognizing it and talking about how
all the time. So, you know, Grandmaster has special stools, and that's my stool.
And kind of like brought us back a little bit of his emotion, so we want to keep his spirit alive as well. And Sensei Mike Sautner keeps Grandmaster Tosin's spirit alive all the time. So, attention, and all right, team, here we go. Big finale coming up.
Thank you, everyone, for taking a moment to make that special for a few of our special black belts and special people to us. So thank you for taking that time to share it with us. Are you ready for the finale? I mean, see, we started off this way. Like, a couple hours ago, we started off. I say, you ready to start? And you went, yeah. And then, okay, all right, let's do it again. Now I'm like, are you ready for the finale? And you're like, yeah.
Let's go.
I'm gonna remix this. This is perfect.
Thank you.
Del Rosario. Sarah Mazuka. Caitlin Wiggins. Liam Prezak. Vivian Tran. Austin, Laura. Cole Styles. And you are. Dana Sanasharan. Matthew and Roman. Sophia DiPietro. And Jaden Walker. Oscar Cruz. Solinsky. Rishinan. Akshay Sobahabi. Gentlemen, it's here for all of our candidates. We're going to have our candidates line up so we can do our belt ceremony. Help them to achieve their goals. But most importantly, represent the martial arts, American martial arts, as best you can. So it's our honor to recognize all of our black belts. Let's give them a round of applause. Reference. We love you, Sensei Dennis. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. One, two, three, and outside.